create while we sleep. They can be entertaining, fun, romantic, disturbing, frightening, and sometimes bizarre. They are an enduring source of mystery for scientists and psychological doctors. Why do dreams occur? What causes them? Can we control them? What do they mean? In this film, we will explore the current theories, causes, and applications of dreaming. We may not remember dreaming, but everyone is thought to dream between 6 and 3 times per night. It is thought each dream lasts between 5 to 20 minutes. Around 95% of dreams are forgotten by the time a person gets out of bed. Dreaming can help you learn and develop long-term memories. Blind people dream more with other sensory components compared with sighted people. Dreams, do they represent our conscious desires? There are several theories about why we dream. Are dreams merely part of the sleep cycle, or do they serve other purpose? Possible explanations include representing unconscious desires and wishes, interpreting random signals from the brain and body during sleep, consolidating and processing information gathered during the day, working as a form of psychotherapy. From evidence and new research methodologies, researchers have speculated that dreaming serves the following functions: offline memory reprocessing, in which the brain consolidates learning and memory tasks and supports and records waking consciousness; preparing for possible future threats; cognitive simulation of real-life experiences, as daydreaming is a subsystem of the waking default network, the part of the mind active during daydreaming; helping develop cognitive capabilities; reflecting unconscious mental function in a psychoanalytic way, a unique state of consciousness that incorporates experience of the present, processing of the past, and preparation for the future; a psychological space where overwhelming, contradictory, or highly complex notions can be brought together by the dreaming ego, notions that would be unsettling while awake, serving the need for psychological balance and equilibrium. Much that remains unknown about dreams. They are by nature difficult to study in a laboratory, but technology and new research techniques may help improve our understanding of dreams. Without dreams, we would slowly go insane. Our brain would shift and break. We would become unbalanced. In a way, our own fantasies keep us grounded. So what happens when you stop dreaming? When you go back to the real world? You might just go the tiniest bit insane.